Hey, what's up everybody? My name is TrophyNut and welcome back to Dark Souls 3. Last time I quite stupidly tumbled off a roof and I lost about 6,000 souls. And since we're back at the start of the Road of Sacrifices, which is actually what the Crestfallen Warrior was talking about, I think, where they the road they used to bring sacrifices to Saint Aldrich. But first, I want those souls back. So you might remember that we had an epic battle with a fire demon wielding an axe, and that Sigurd of Katarina helped us with that. I'm not gonna stumble in. Let's pull the lever. And then I need to go up, bring the elevator down again, and then go up even more. And that should end me back where I was. This elevator does remind me of the one in the old Hunters DLC in Bloodborne, where you also, with the altar on top, that brings you to the research lab. Because you had to do the exact same thing. So let it drop down, there was something below it, and there was something underneath in the lower elevator as well. Wait, I need to get on, and yeah, this direction I think, and then wait until I see a light. Yeah, there we go. It's not that hard if you get the timing right. That fire demon should be gone. Yeah, I think Sigurd is even gone. I'm gonna call him Sigurd. He calls himself Sigurd even though he looks like Siegmeier. And there goes our friend the giant again. Look at him up there. Don't look down my skirt. Look up there. It doesn't look like he's firing arrows from here, but... okay. So let's get back inside here. And hopefully not die, because I do want those souls back. I don't think there was anything particular about this room. They were just hanging. I need to wake them up. There is an area over here, but I probably shouldn't be able to reach that. So there's a few up there I shouldn't worry about. Oh yeah, over here. And this was the room they all dropped down from. There we go. And then the other dog. So always just wait and let him bounce off the shield. And now. So now we need to be careful. Is he gonna start dropping? Well, that's a way. Maybe quickly heal up a bit, and then we only need to take care of those two dudes upstairs. And so I should be able to get a few fireballs in as I did before. Gonna drop myself down a bit. Okay, let's get going. So now she'll try to catch me. There we go. Not taking any chances with these ladies. And I think I can confirm that they are women. Nope. Took out all my Estus. Wait, what? Why did I get another Ashen Flask? See, that it happened again. I don't know if anyone of you can tell me why that happens. Oh. I think I missed one. So yeah, let's drink that up. I don't know why that happens, that I get an extra charge once in a while. So first, I want to get my souls back. It was over here. Yeah, there we go. Not gonna fall this time. Kind of fell because that roof is a bit skewed in the wrong direction. Was there anything below here that I didn't check? So I could go over here. And then to the sides here. Doesn't look like it. Okay, so I did want to check what's down there by falling correctly. Huh, it's below. Yeah, that's still the same message. So, dropping. That looks fine. And then I can drop over here. And we're somewhere else completely now. Oh, there is an item here, another homeward bone. Is that a way, the way of the game telling me that I need to go back? If there is no way here? Oh my god. I have too many souls to try this. Oh, for fuck's sake. And then somewhere, but do I really want to? Okay, okay. I survived that. Okay, fuck. I wanted to reach those planks over there, but time for rolling and then there. Yeah, indeed. Chloranti ring. Oh yes, I know what that is. That's for stamina recovery speed. This old ring is named for its decorative green blossom, but its luster is long since faded. Raises stamina recovery speed. Hell yes. So I'm gonna equip that instead of the blue tearstone ring. Because it ups it quite a bit, as you can see. Mira. Ooh, I forgot her name, but there was a character in Dark Souls 2 that was from Mira. I'm gonna do that, and then I'm gonna quickly check what the outfit is. Mira Vest, garb worn by Mira knights sent on journeys. This hard leather vest is bestowed only upon proven knights. Knights travel afar to fulfill their sacred duties, but few are ever able to deliver on their vows. I'm gonna check in a minute if I can wear that, because that's actually pretty cool equipment. So that's the same thing. Yeah. And then the trousers, also the same thing. Let's see about that. It does put me over half. But it looks so awesome that I can't leave that behind. I'm still quick rolling. I think it's 70%. You need to be under. So I'm at a side tower. Oh, from the tree. Okay then. First gonna check behind here. Maybe I missed something as well. Nope. Seems like a cave-in and, well, wasteland. I am really doubting whether I should use a homeward bone right about now. Because if I drop down here, where does that take me? Nowhere yet. I do want to eventually return to the tree, but I first want to use my 7,000 souls. Nope, you don't. Oh, evangelist robe and evangelist trousers. So that's probably going to confirm that those are women. Evangelist robe. Robe of an evangelist sent from the cathedral. These teachers, all women, there we go, came to enlighten inhabitants of the undead settlement and sent carriers on the path of sacrifice. Creepy. And then the trousers, yeah, it's the same thing. So they came from the cathedral to teach these. To teach these poor bastards about enlightenment. Well, I don't know what kind of enlightenment they were teaching, but it's kind of creepy. How do I get back up to the bonfire? Hello. No, you don't. Oh, my stamina was out. To get another hit in. I wonder, they keep talking about sacrifices. Maybe. Don't explode, don't explode, don't explode. Maybe the sacrifices are those books with flesh those fellows are carrying. The other one isn't here, so let's head to the bonfire. And a quick warp towards Firelink Shrine. And then I'll probably head towards that tree, finally. Because it's been a while since we've seen that thing for the first time. There we go. I would upgrade this frost sword if I had some twinkling titanite.
Welcome home, Ashen One. Speak the very well. Then
my heart's desire is to level up. Can I do 2 levels? Not quite. I'm gonna go with a bit more dexterity, maybe even use a consumable, so I need to go to 4580. There we go.
Farewell, me.
And then in the inventory. It's rubbish, actually. Who in their right mind would bother carrying this around? Perhaps you need help. Okay, so use all those fading souls. That's probably 250 in its entirety. Yeah. And then Unknown Traveler. I haven't used these, I think. Yeah, there we go. We're high enough. We're high enough. High on souls. So, another one in dexterity. There we go.
Farewell, Ashen, may the flame.
So, since we're gonna be dealing with that tree, I'm gonna equip accordingly. I'm gonna take my fire sword. Probably two-handed even, but I'm gonna keep my shield for the enemies before that. I might even remove the talisman, since I don't really need it. There we go. I think that's it. The rings are pretty good. I don't know if it has any status effects. Did I found another Estus shard, by the way? Not really sure anymore. Doesn't look like it. But I believe someone said I might have missed something.
Just what neat.
Okay. Because I think I missed one in the beginning. So I might want to get that one as well. So let's travel. And I think it was from here. I'm not gonna get to that tree just about now. I'm first gonna get that Estus shard. So yeah. Worker hat. I think I already had one of those. So let's go down. And then let's kill this guy. There we go. And then those little fellows over here. So I'm gonna walk over here and then he drops down. And then he dies. And then down here are two more. As I see one over there even. And then this little fellow. And then we can get out pretty safely. And try to lure out a few of these guys, because I think the Estus shard is down where that guy is kneeling, and I'm fucking blind apparently. So let's lure these guys out one at a time. Worker garb. Oh, that might have been a mistake. Bugs incoming. Let's get it, oh. Oh, shit. Whew. That was fucking close.
Cleanse the bastard's curse.
Well, the first time I actually understood what she was saying. And probably this guy. And then just to be, well, no, I'm not gonna actually activate those barrels. Heard you, boyo. And then take this from the fire. Yeah, there we go, Estus shard. I never actually read the description of an Estus shard. Gift to the blacksmith at the shrine to increase the usages of the Estus flask, probably. In the old days, it was rare to see an Estus flask far from its owner. The shard offers hope, however shattered. So I'm gonna return to Firelink Shrine, do that, and then we'll try and take a crack at that tree. Andre, where art thou? Well, my Estus flask needs smithing. So 5-1 is still okay. I've never needed more than one extra Ashen Flask. I also think I never saw that pilgrim again, that sorcerer, I think. Because we found a pyromancer, but we found that worm-faced... Oh, here we are. That guy. Hello, mister.
Oh, our champion of Ash. Welcome.
Why are you looking at my boobs?
This pilgrim, with a debt in death, hardly deserves to behold this divine flame.
Yes, and you're beholding something, all right.
You've not taken me into your service. I thank you dearly.
You
for
perverted
this,
old man.
And assure you of my leal service.
Is that an old word for loyal? Draw out true strength. Well, y'all. Draw out my true strength.
Then shall we begin? Bearer of the dark sign, let your true strength shine.
Okay, then. Wait, can I use another... Oh, I can add one free level. Oh, that's awesome. I am, by the way, using Dexterity because that also speeds up my casting time. So Dexterity and Intelligence will be my focus from now on until we hit the soft cap of those. And then with a few points into Endurance and Vigor along the way. So, Dexterity again. Thank you. What do you sell? Also Soul Arrows. Well, I might as well. Let's talk.
As I have said, I was once a sorcerer. Alas, the magic of Londor is a far cry from the wonders of Vinheim.
Oh, I do hope we finally get
but
to visit Vinheim in this game.
Perhaps, more importantly, I believe that I can help tease out your true strength. We pilgrims of Londor are keenly aware that those branded by the dark sign possess something quite special.
I wonder how often you can do that, beckon.
As I have said, alas, but I can. I believe that we. That those.
Yeah, okay. So, yeah.
Be safe, champion of Ash.
Thank you, y'all. So we still have about 800 souls left. Okay, I heard monsters above. So I might as well spend that at the lady. Lady, there we go. The handmaiden. So purchase a few things, maybe even a homeward bone. Nah, I'm gonna buy this catalyst since I am using quite a bit of magic, and then maybe a torch. There we go.
Ashen one.
Okay, so now we should be prepared to take on the Rotten Great Tree, I think was the name. Probably somewhere special. Oh yeah, and I should attune that miracle. Or even Fire Surge. Huh. So let's travel, since we're gonna need fire. I think the fastest way will be from that cliff. Yeah, I think so. Since we can run straight down those steps into the area where that tree is. Mortician's Ashes. So I do want to try out. Was there something dying? Okay, I can do this pretty... How far does that reach? Ooh, pretty far. I'm gonna do this again. And then I think if I run out... Oh, that's the wrong way. Well, hey. So it's the other way around, apparently. So rest. And if I run, I might outrun that mob that comes out of the out from the bridge. Running. Something following me. Nope. I'm actually pretty far ahead. So I'm gonna use the shield to start with, but after that I'm probably gonna switch to two-handing my fire sword. So yeah, wish me luck. It doesn't start awake, that's also something I find peculiar. There also isn't really a hiding spot, sadly. There it goes. Okay, didn't really get hit there. Hit him in the eggs. Hit him in the nuts! I killed his eggs. Oh! Whoa! What the f- I survived that, apparently. Holy mother. Does leave something on the ground. Okay. Damn it. There we go. Drop down. There we go. That should kill everything else. Oh fuck. Can block his stuff.
And he puts his hand back. Turn attack, I think. Yeah, there he goes. And then he puts his hand back. That's one I missed. Okay. Am I dead? I'm not dead. God damn it, that was rolling. I got this. Just need to be careful. Okay, turn around on me. Well. Yeah, there we go. Almost there, almost there. Okay. That's perfect. There we go. Yes! Eat it! In the face, soul of the rotted Greatwood, air of fire. Destroyed, and a transposing kiln. Wow! Whew, that was a cool boss. A bit gross, but... Oh look, souls! Probably almost nothing, but... 800. More than I thought it would be, so let's check out that soul. So yeah, fire is the way to go, and there were eggs on the sides of it. And if you destroyed those, it got staggered for a bit. So that was even cooler. That's a giant soul, Jesus. Used to acquire blah blah blah. Ever since its establishment, all manner of curses have managed to seep into the undead settlement. The worst of them were sealed away inside a spirit tree, but eventually the curses took their toll. So they sealed the curses away in the spirit tree, and that transformed the tree into that rotted Greatwood. And what was that transposing kiln? Maybe on the keys? Yeah. An old transposing kiln from Corland, crafted with stitched crystal lizard hide. Give to Ludlit, Lord of Cinder, to conduct soul transposition. This kiln can transpose twisted souls to craft special items with their concentrated essence. Deemed forbidden by those unable to make proper use of it. So, can Ludlit then make me boss weapons? With those souls? That would be awesome. There are a few items over here, and it does seem to end here, so I'm probably gonna need to continue elsewhere. So, Homeward Bone. And a War God wooden shield. Let's check it like this. War God wooden shield. 84 physical damage, physical reduction, 4 weight, which actually weighs less than the shield I'm actually using. And it looks like a great shield, actually. Wooden shield reinforced with metal, the largest of the wooden medium shields. Oh, so it's still a medium shield. The bizarre pattern featured on the shield is the mark of a mad god revered as a god of war in remote regions. Is that a hint to actual god of war, or is that just me? Is it like that red drawing on Kratos? Weapon skill. Equipping the shield in the left hand allows one to perform the skill of the right hand weapon. Cool. But I am gonna keep my eagle guide shield, which does actually the exact same thing. Okay. Is there anything else here? Oh. I am gonna first activate this bonfire. And then rest at it, just in case something horrible happens. And then let's pray, I suppose. Pray at sacrificial altar. Offer vertebra shackle. No vertebra shackle in inventory. So I don't know what that's for, but it looks cool. Look at these rafters all lined with candles. How the hell did those people do that? So let's go
We're back to Firelink Shrine real quickly. Pit of Hollows. That's weird, all the other ones were called after their bosses' names, like Vort and Udex Gundyr, but that one isn't. Weird. So, Firelink Shrine.